Hello, hello from the state of Indiana, and welcome back after this wonderful weekend that we had here. It was pretty warm, but anyways, it is Monday, August 8th of 2011, and we are looking at the Q's Daily Chart, and of course, Carolina here from Grok Trade, a graduate student, and I'm just getting ready to show you some incredible stuff that we see on, that actually I see here on the chart. We've had a significant down day on the markets here today, with the Dow Jones dropping over 600 points to the downside, making it the biggest one-day drop since 2008, and the Q's being down over 6%. That is huge. And as you can see, we are dropping and breaking through all significant areas of support, being still down below, way below all major moving averages right here. The first one that you see here in green, which is the 8 moving average, my favorite one. The second one here in red, which is the 50-day moving average. And the next one here in blue is the 200-day moving average, which is huge. That's a huge deal. We are really bearish according to all major moving averages as well as our areas of support. We keep breaking all major areas of support on our way down, heading lower. So that's what it is here. That's what I see. And as you can see, we had that big down day here, the big drop on the markets today, with a confirmation on the MACD pointing lower. We're still way below the zero line, which is bearish on a pretty significant volume. But check this out. The volume is spiking up big time. What does that mean? Are we about to be putting on a bottom? Could be, but we don't know. We don't know yet. We need to wait for a certain formation to form to let us know that we are about to turn around and head back up. But first of all, we will have to have a pretty nice bullish formation formed on our chart, together with the confirmation on the MACD pointing a little bit lower, pointing a little bit higher, pointing north. And also we would have to see that increase in volume again to confirm that bottom. So that's what could happen. But anyways, yeah, let's look at some other areas of support on our way down that we need to pay close attention to right after the one that we hit today. And the next one on our way down would be at the 4964 mark, so put that on your chart, as well as the other one down below would be at the 4882 mark. And then the next big one would be a little lower than the two previous ones, and it would be here at the 4695 mark. So that would be significant area support that you need to pay really close attention to if we go lower. But if we do get a little bit of a bounce after that huge drop, we've had so many down days on our chart so far, so we are ready for a little bit of a pullback. And if we do get one, we could head all the way back up to that upper area of resistance right here, the 5380 mark. We could head all the way up there, and then we could form a lower swing highs on the Q's on our daily chart, and then we could turn around and then continue lower, breaking through the 55 mark again to the downside. So that's what I see here on our chart if we have at least two different scenarios to watch for. So watch for that little bounce if we ever get one, and watch that upper area of resistance at 5377 mark, as well as watch all other areas of support on our way down if we ever had lower, and watch the MACD to look for confirmation and pay close attention to the volume to see if we're going to get any more spikes in volume. All right, so have a wonderful evening, and I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.